क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 ऑफ पेपर नंबर 2, देयर इट इज गिवन पी की पावर 3 इंटू वी की पावर 5 इज कॉन्स्टेंट, दैट मीन्स पी वी की पावर 5/3 इज कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर अ एडियाबेटिक प्रोसेस, दैट मीन्स फॉर द गैस गामा इक्वल टू 5/3, सी पी हैपन्स टू बी 5/2 आर एंड सी वी हैपन्स टू बी 3/2 आर. सो द गैस इज मेड टू अंडरगो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल एन आइसोबारिक प्रोसेस एज यू कैन सी ऑन द पी वी डायग्राम एंड देन आइसोकोरिक प्रोसेस ऑन द पी वी डायग्राम. वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द टोटल heat given to the gas during this particular process. During the isobaric process, we can say heat given is NCP delta T, which is nothing but 5/2 NR delta T. NR delta T by ideal gas equation, we can write as P initial into V final minus V initial. And similarly, in the second process, when the process is isochoric, the heat given is NCV delta T, where we can say CV is 3/2 R. So this becomes 3/2 into NR delta T2. Now, NR into delta T by ideal gas equation, again it becomes delta P multiplied by volume. Obviously, this thing will be negative, this thing will be positive. If we sum up both of them, then the total heat given comes out to be 587.5 joules, which can be rounded off to 588 joules. So, in this particular case, the answer will be C. Here, there is a lens and then there is a spherical mirror. First of all, object for the lens is at 50 centimeter. So by using lens formula, we get the image of the lens is formed at 75 centimeter from the lens on the principal axis. That means 25 centimeter behind the mirror on the principal axis of the lens. But since the principal axis of the mirror is inclined at an angle of 30 degree to this particular axis, the object or the mirror is located at 25√3/2 from the mirror, and its height from the principal axis of the mirror is 25/2 centimeter. Now, taking the mirror formula, U2 equal to 25√3/2 plus 25√3/2, I am using Cartesian sign convention, we get V2 equal to U2 into F upon U2 minus F, which gives us V2 equal to minus 50√3 upon 4√3, and H2 equal to H1 into F upon U2 minus F using the magnification formula. So, height of this image comes out to be 50 upon 4√3. This is happening to be a real image, virtual object, and a real image. Virtual object real image will be something like this. This will be a erect image. The virtual object real image is always an erect image. The height will be something like this. So if I want to find out its x coordinate of this particular image, then I can say x coordinate will be given by this V2. 50 is this particular distance. 50 minus V2 cos of 30 degree. 50 minus V2 cos 30 degree plus H2 cos of 60 degree. If we calculate, it comes out to be approximately 25 centimeter. And if I look at the y coordinate comes out to be V2 sin 30 degree plus H2 sin 60 degree. And we calculate, it comes out to be close to 25√3 centimeter. So going by the spirit of IITJ, we say that the answer will be R, although the answer is only approximate. Here, there is a YDIC experiment with a slight difference. Here, S1 and S2, originally they were slits, but because they were covered by holes, so they become pinholes. So here there are two pinholes. They will produce an interference pattern on this screen, which is held perpendicular to the plane of slits. So, in this particular case, suppose there is one particular point at which the path difference is n lambda. We can imagine that if we make a circular arc, then in that particular circular arc at all the points, we can imagine that the path difference will be equal to n lambda. So, the fringes where the interference is there as maxima is given by a circular. I would not say it is a completely circular because the upper part of the screen only is visible. So that's why we will get semicircular fringes. As far as the option C is concerned, the region very close to point O, if we see the path difference over there, the path difference is equal to the distance D between slits S1 and S2. That comes out to be 6003 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter. Lambda is given to be 6 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter. So from that, the delta X comes out to be actually 1000 plus half lambda. And since this is of the form of n plus half lambda, that's why this point is a minima. So, region very close to point O will be dark. So, in this case, the answer will be Bombay and Calcutta. Particular question, that formula for time period of a pendulum, a particular pendulum has been given 2π√7 r − r/g. Now, the error in time period has to be found out. Error in r and small r are given. How do you find out the error in time period? For that, we go by the average of the time. First of all, we find out the average time period. That comes out to be 0.56 seconds. The error in each of the readings that is given as 0.52 0.56, 0.57, 0.54 and 0.59 error in each reading is to be formed. And taking the modulus of each of the errors and average of those modulus, we get the average error in the whole experiment for the time period. That average error comes out to be 0.02 seconds. That means this average error delta t upon the t time period, this will give us the error as 3.57%. Percentage error is this much. The percentage error in radius small r comes out to be 10%, because delta r key value is given to be 1. So 1 by 10 in percent, this is 10%. Now manipulating this particular formula, we get g equal to 4 pi square by t square into 7 capital R minus small r. So the error in g, percentage error in g, is calculated to be delta r plus delta r. The reason it is because the error is always added, delta r plus small delta r upon r minus r plus 2 delta t by t. By calculating that, the error, percentage error in delta g in g is found out to be 11%. So for us, the answer is Agra, Bombay and Delhi.